my goodness. What's up, money geeks? Mr. V here. Welcome to another video, guys. So in today's video, we're gonna take a look at 5 stocks that are still 50% off. We know that we had that huge sell-off in March when things went really south for a lot of companies. Ever since, there's been a little bounce back, a little squeeze on the upside, and a lot of companies are some are even starting to see their 52-week high already, even though we're still in lockdown. But there's still other companies that are great companies, they're solid companies, and companies that have been around for a while that are still struggling to even get back to just 50% of the sell-off. So we're going to take a look at 5 of this company today. But before we get started, guys, if you're new to the channel, we talk about how to earn money, how to save money, how to invest and build wealth. So if that's something that interests you, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss out on new content. And also, just because YouTube wants you to do it, so it helps my channel. So let's jump on the computer, kind of go through it and just see each of these stocks and why I think they're 50% off, but they still have a great upside. So let's jump right in. So here we go, guys. So the first company on the list here is ticker symbol BA. So that would be Boeing. Let me kind of really zoom out here so we can see. Let's go to the week calendar so that we can see exactly how Boeing has been moving around. So if we go here, so this is let's just go to say this is May of 2019. So I want to be in 2020. Sorry, guys. All right, so let's go to 2020. If we see as of December, Boeing was trading at close to about $367. That's just in December. So fast forward in January, Boeing was somewhere around $365 still, right? And then here comes March, where we had that huge, massive sell-off. Look at how the thing collapsed. So Boeing goes from looking at maybe, this is February 14, looking at $345, and then huge sell-off. It drops down all the way to $89. This is insane. I'm bullish on Boeing. A lot of you already know, if you've been following my channel, you know that I like Boeing. I like the business model. I like the fact that they do a lot of contracts with the Defense Department and the government. I like the fact that the president talks about them a lot. So there's a company that they're not gonna just let go bankrupt just like that. Right now they're having some issues, but I'm pretty sure that they're gonna resolve those issues and get back on track. So if you missed out on this particular bottom right here, $89 from, again, $349, that was insane. And then after that bottom, it started to squeeze up a little bit. So notice, like, we got this little squeeze here, and it went up to a high of about 184, and then pulled back again, and it's just been around this 120 to 140 area. And I think as of today, when I was doing this video, it was about 144. So if you look at that from that perspective, 144 out of 349 in February, that is crazy. That is even less. No, I'm talking about 50% off. That's almost 60% off if we do the math. So I'm still bullish and I like them. So if you didn't get in here at $89, there's still a chance. I personally got some at 90 something dollars, then started averaging up as the price went up. So I think my average right now is I think 115 or so. I do have a lot of Boeing, so and I feel strong about it. I feel good about it. I'm not worried about anything about them going bankrupt. So I'm just gonna sit back and wait for the ride to go up back to $300. And if things go okay, I mean, I'm anticipating $400. So that's just me. Do your research before you put your money on the line like I do. So that is number one. So let's jump up to number ticker symbol. Here would be RTX, Radiant Technology. Again, this is another company that I'm really bullish on. After their merger with UTX, I really kind of like what I saw there. So if we take a look here, just before the crash in February, they were at about 158. And then here comes the crash. If you can see these candles here, see how just how bad that is. Like it just kind of went down. So went down and then kind of squeezed back up. And then when they did their merger with UTX, so they split the share price. And so I think it came back at, I don't know, it was like 50 something or 60 bucks per share after that merger. And then ever since then, it's just been around the 60 and $50 price range. But again, the upside to this is your business model. Doing contracts with the military, we know very well that the Defense Department doesn't mess around with your spending. So companies like this, unless some massive scandal really comes out, companies like this are just going to be just fine. So I'm going to sit back. I have a good position in Radeon. So I'm going to sit back and just watch it go up. And I'm anticipating getting back to 150. So that is, you know, my number two. So let's move on to number three. Number three here is ticker symbol NCLH. Again, I've done a video about these guys here on the channel, Norwegian Cruise. Look at that. Before the crash, and you can totally see it on the graph here, man. It's ridiculous, like some bloody waterfall. So from a high of about $59, close to $60 back in January, and here comes the crash. It dropped down all the way to about $7. This is ridiculous, guys. And then see, it did a little bit of a pullback. This is a squeeze there on the upside, but that didn't really materialize. All cruises are still grounded. They're not running. No business is taking place right now. So very difficult for them to make any kind of move. But as of right now, they are trading at about 16 bucks. That's better than $7. So there's an upside, and they are talking about, you know, at least sailing this year yet. So that maybe September or October, they anticipate that they're going to be in the waters sailing with their customers. And then one other thing that I like about Norwegian Cruise Tour is that they've raised enough money to keep them afloat for another 18 months if they don't sail, which is great. If you have enough money to keep you afloat for that long, 18 months, that's excellent. That is a good sign of a healthy company, in my opinion, the fact that they have that kind of money to operate even when they're not bringing any revenue. So that's why I like them. So let's move on to number four, WBA. So if we take a look here, let's go to our 2020. That's where we want to be, okay? All right. So this is February before the crash. Right here, December 2019, it was up to about $64 and some change. January, they were up, it's about $51. Then fast forward, the crash came in and this whole thing dropped down to about $38. And when I was doing this video, they're trading at about $40-something and some change. So not quite 50% yet, but I mean, there's still a tremendous amount of upside. So all things being equal, if they continue to do the right things and stores open up, if we can just get it back to the 52-week high prior to the crash, it's still sitting pretty good. And then let's take number five would be DAL, ticker symbol DAL. This would be Delta Airlines. So this is again another terrible one. If you look at before the crash, $62 and some change. Here comes the crash in March, dropped all the way down to about $18 and change. And then kind of squeezed back up and then couldn't hold that particular confirmation, came back down. And since then, it's just been hovering somewhere around, I'll say $22 and $25. But Delta Airlines is a massive airline, so I don't anticipate them going through some really hard time and filing for bankruptcy or any of that stuff. So I'm going to sit back here, watch this one. And just give it opportunity, because as soon as people start flying, they're gonna be just fine. The only thing holding is like people are still not flying, people are freaked out. So if we get a vaccine, people get back on the plane and start flying, it's gonna be just she's fine. So those are the five. And then one bonus one that I want to add here is PBA, Pembina Pipeline. So this is a pipeline company. And this one is, I think it's not 50%. It's kind of about 30 or 25% off right now. Coming into the crash, they were trading at about $40. And then here comes the crash and it drops all the way down to about $10. And then as you see, it's just gradually being squeezing up. So this particular, let's see. So this, I would say $10.50 that was the bottom. So, which is kind of crazy because most people cannot really predict, what the bottom is going to be. So look at that rejection came all the way down to $10.50. And then I still haven't had any confirmation yet. So it's just consolidating around $25 right now. So hopefully if we can consolidate, get some confirmation, get out of there. Again, most of these companies are basically just waiting for the economy to get back on track and they'll be just fine. So here we go. That is the five companies and the bonus one that I just added in there for you guys. That are, I would say, 50% off. Again, do your research, guys. This is my personal take. The companies that I just put on here, I do like them. I think they have some great upside. So if you think like, hey, this is the companies that you want to go and do your research properly. I didn't go into the financials or anything of these companies. I'm just solely looking at the health of the company based on what the service that they provide and how people are used to these companies. And so we can go look back in details in the different financials to make even better decisions. So yes, if you do have any questions about my list, don't hesitate again to drop that in the comment section. If you have some other suggestions of stocks that you think are still currently highly undervalued, don't hesitate, guys, to share with us in the comment section. Again, if you're new to the channel, we talk about how to earn money, how to save money, how to invest and build wealth. If that's something that interests you, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss out on new content. And as always, guys, stay safe and stay motivated.